In IP television, the companies that will succeed will be no different conceptually than any other competitive market. They are going to be the companies that have assets that they can leverage adequately to compete effectively. And those, at this moment, are content, which is proprietary, an ability to find what I need, or maybe the ability to group different services. For instance, that I can watch a television program live and simultaneously in the same screen be able to chat with my friends or use Facebook or Twitter or whatever. Traditional broadcasting companies will have a very hard time to compete because they have traditionally been making money by using a differential asset, which was a license to operate in a given frequency. When you have a finite or a very small number of channels, 4, 5, or even 30 different channels, used to have a programming style, and they would buy programs that would blend together to attract a given segment of audience. When you have the ability to have thousands or tens of thousands or even millions of channels, if you take into account user-generated content, it's very hard to be able to differentiate yourself by grouping in a proprietary manner a given sequence of programs because they can be sold directly by the generators of the content, producing companies. And the grouping can be done by many people, by bloggers, by peer-to-peer networks, by many newspapers. Many people can tell you what you may be interested on. So I think that the future for traditional network television as we know it today is bleak, to say the least. In a market with lots of content spread around the internet, the user needs some facility to be able to find what it is looking for, what he or she is looking for. You need somebody to direct you by title to that place. That somebody is a search engine. So the search engine is a necessary intermediary and can leverage this position by charging you and repaying then the rightful owner. So there are many business models may be developed over there. A different player that can leverage its own assets is the telecommunications operator. Verizon in the US, for instance, is offering a service that leveraging their fiber optic network to the final consumer can offer you a split screen where you can do peer-to-peer networking on one side and watch in high definition live events in another part of the screen. This kind of service is going to be very hard to be offered by people without the infrastructure. My belief is that there is a very large price elasticity, and that if the price is sufficiently low, many people that now are either pirating the content through peer-to-peer networks or basically not watching it will do so. iTunes has proven it in music, that by lowering the price enough, they have sold billions of songs that can be obtained in peer-to-peer networks for free, and therefore, but there are many people that are willing to pay the rightful price for this thing. And in television, it doesn't have to be any different.